Hey, what's going on, guys? Well, in this video, we're going to take a look at the Korth Mongoose versus the Manurhin MR73. So, I'm not going to get into like specifics on each of these revolvers. You can go on Google and search them up yourself. But this is kind of a high-level perspective of owning both of these revolvers, shooting them a lot, and give you an idea of what I personally feel about each one of these revolvers. Okay. So these are a little bit different than your standard run-of-the-mill Smith & Wesson, Smith & Wesson Performance Centers, okay, any second generation, newly produced Colt Pythons or Snake Guns, Rugers, Taurus, Charter Arms, you get the picture. These two specific revolvers are manufactured at a little bit higher level in the sense that they're using higher quality components, and both of these revolvers do still require a little bit of hand fitting in the parts, but they do stand out from a standard old Smith & Wesson. We'll just put it like that. Now, again, I'm not going to go through specs. I'm just going to talk high level here. First off, people, I guess, you know, they get upset or they get angry at these two model revolvers for whatever reason. A lot of people think they're junk, that they break easily, that they're not worth the money, that like they go out of time after like 300 rounds. Okay, I've heard everything. The finish comes right off on the MR73. The Korth Mongoose finish looks terrible. It makes it look like a Taurus. And then the hammer breaks off of it. All this weird stuff, people out there, when they come to the videos of, you know, watching videos on my Mongoose or the MR73, a lot of negativity, a lot of hatred. And, you know, that's just how it goes. So, the cost of these revolvers, yes, they are not inexpensive by any means. And is it worth that cost? That's what a lot of people ask me. I cannot answer that. You know, I mean, if you're into revolvers, if you're an aficionado, you're an enthusiast, then it might be worth it to you. You might go all out and get an MR73. You might go all out and get a Mongoose. You might go get a Jans. All right, you might get a Spore. Yes, yes. I know what a Spore is. Everyone's like, hey, stupid, have you ever heard of Spore? The Spore revolver is superior to the Korth Mongoose and the MR73. But that person has never owned one or even touched one. So how do they know? just a little fun fact. Back in December of 2023, I almost put in an order for a Spore 284 carry because I couldn't find the MR73. So I stopped myself, and I'm glad I did. I said, I'm going to stick to my guns and get the MR73. So I did not order the 284 carry. I do like what I see with Spore, but there's something about it. And, you know, my gut is telling me not to get one right now. I like the videos I see about them. The owner, that Club Edition 3.0, I think it's called, with the 3-inch barrel. That's very interesting to me. But again, it's just there's something I'm going to wait. All right, back on track here. So, yes, the cost, that's going to be up to you if you think it's worth it. The other thing was a lot of people were like, why would you carry that gun? Yes, I am carrying the MR73 part-time, not full. This is not a full-time CCW, but I have carried it on the streets a handful of times so far. I am still waiting for a custom holster for this, which I don't even know. Maybe I'm not going to get it, I guess. I don't know. Who knows what's happening with that? But I do have a Falco that I use that works out, okay? So I have been carrying this, and in 2022, I carried this Mongoose on and off throughout the whole year. And a lot of people will say, well, why would you do that, stupid? Oh, yeah, if you get into a good shoot, you know, it's going to get taken away from you and put in an evidence locker. You'll never see it again. Well, oh, well, I guess I'll never see this gun again. If this firearm here saves my life and my loved ones' lives and innocence, it's done its job and it served its purpose. Trust me on this. If you're involved in any type of quote-unquote good shooting, you are not going to be thinking about guns. You are not going to be thinking about getting this gun back. You're not going to be thinking about firearms or want to watch another firearms video. Trust me on this. Your brain, your mind is going to be on a lot of other things. You're going to have a lot more things to worry about than trying to get this gun back from an evidence locker. Really. You may not even want this gun back after a situation like that. These are replaceable, okay? I know it's, yeah, they're not inexpensive, but they are still replaceable. Your life, you're alive. So don't worry about that. If you want to carry it, carry it. These are highly reliable revolvers. These are highly accurate revolvers. And both of these revolvers shoot phenomenal because of the trigger systems. So let's kind of dive into this some more. Now, the trigger systems in both the Mongoose and the MR73 are adjustable. That's pretty cool. So you can adjust the trigger weight, the hammer, all that other good stuff. I have not done that. I left them stock right out of the box because they work just fine. They really do. This one here, maybe I could mess with a little bit. I'm not sure yet. I could, it might make it a little bit better. But the Mongoose out of the box is perfect. I love it. The trigger weights on both, because I was at the range one day and someone did have a trigger weight mechanism. And we did measure the double action trigger, right, on both of these revolvers. And I wrote them down here. So the MR73 was just about 8 pounds, double action. And the Mongoose was just about 8 pounds, double action. So they're both like 8 pounds, double action. Single action, this one here was almost 4 pounds. And this was more close to 3 pounds. So this was lighter than this one. Almost 4 pounds, single action. Close to 3 pounds, single action. So take it for what it's worth. Now, me personally, which one do I like better? Man, I can't make a decision on that. But I do really like the MR73 now. Just the way it looks, how classic it is. When I open the cylinder, you push that cylinder release forward. It just feels so smooth. And the cylinder pops out, very precise. You push on this ejector rod, it's smooth as glass. The way it responds like that, it's just, everything about this revolver is fine-tuned, just awesome. Now this barrel here is, if you want to call it a one-piece barrel, there's no shroud around the barrel. Cold hammer forge. Again, I don't want to get through all the specs. It's just an awesome revolver, okay? The sights, yeah, they're hard to see, all right? This front blade up here is all serrated, so cuts glare, and this serrated up here cuts glare, but it's all blacked out, all right? They're saying these are combat sights. They work well, but under low light situations, yeah, that's when you get kind of iffy. But just, I'm used to just pointing guns, whether it be a revolver to a 1911, to a Glock, HKUSP, SIG P226, whatever. I seem to be able to have that instinctive point. But yeah, it would be nice to have maybe a front colored, front sight, so it would pop a little bit. Do I want to take some white out? No, I don't. I'm going to leave it alone. But, they're fine sights. They're good sights. The rear is adjustable, right? And the thing about this one here is the trigger. Now, I want to talk about this trigger, how it's designed. It's got serrations on the front of the trigger face, and it's very sharp for some reason on the edges of the trigger right here, the edges. So when I fired 50 rounds of 158 grain magnums out of this, all right, 50 rounds, my finger, trigger finger, in two spots here and here, started to develop a blister and almost a paper cut. So it's very, very kind of sharp edge. Like if I took my fingernail and just went like that to it, you'll see some, it pulls some of my fingernail out. So that's interesting that the trigger is kind of sharp like that. Definitely grips your trigger finger when you roll this back. But yeah, it's not the most comfortable trigger, we'll say. So after 100 rounds of magnums, My finger was just like, it just started to become raw. So I could wear a glove and continue shooting. But yeah, after 100 rounds of magnums, yeah, it just wasn't comfortable. So that's interesting how this trigger face and the actual trigger itself is kind of sharp and it grips your finger like mad. Other than that, the trigger roll on this is very nice. You just keep pulling it back. It's incredibly smooth. And again, it's like 8 pounds. On the Mongoose, we'll talk about the Mongoose now. The trigger here, I love it. The trigger face is ultra highly polished, smooth. It just feels really good on the finger right here. I like the way this feels when I, rolled the trigger on this one. Like that. And if I were, I haven't put that many rounds through this one this year, but last year I definitely put a good amount of magnums through this. But this year, no, not really. I'm working on putting magnums through the MR73. But After 100 rounds of 158 grain magnums, not a problem at all. It's very comfortable. I could shoot it. It's fine. So this Mongoose right here, I'm going to say is a little bit easier to shoot. And I don't want to say control. It's just something about the Mongoose. It's just a little more, I don't know, fun to shoot for some reason. So as you can see, the cylinder release is up here for some wacky reason. My other Korth Mongoose has a traditional cylinder release, which I like. But this one here, everyone mistakes this as a thumb safety up here. Anyways, the cylinder release is up here, which is, you know, you could get used to it. But for me, I prefer it just right here because I've been used to just doing this, just like that. So it is a little strange, but I can get used to it. It's nicely serrated on top. It's a round, you know, circular designs because you can catch onto it almost in different angles, basically. So, and that's the cylinder. And the Mongoose, again, the ejector rod, very, very glassy smooth. Again, everything just feels so damn refined and precise on the Mongoose and on the MR73. I like the finish, actually, on this Mongoose. I know a lot of people say it just looks cheap, but I'm telling you, you shoot this thing, and especially on my 6-inch Mongoose, has had a lot of rounds through it. And I wasn't the only person that put those rounds through it, but that one has had a ton of rounds through it. And hold on, let me go get it. I'll show it to you. So this Mongoose right here, okay, has had a ton of rounds through it, like a lot. And if you look at the finish, it doesn't show any type of wear. I'm going to open up the cylinder here. And if we look inside, look at the recoil blast shield, whatever you want to call it, where the breech face is. Now, as you can see, the front of the cylinder, you can tell it's been shot a lot. But if you look inside here, and the other cool thing about Korth Mongoose is you press this button right here, and you can remove the cylinder. No, I do not own any 9mm cylinder for either one of these, nor do I want one. I have a Smith 986. And you know what? I'm not really that big of a fan of shooting 9mm out of the revolvers. But anyways, just look in there. There's no real wear after thousands of rounds went through this. See that? So the DLC, diamond-like carbon coating finish, stands up. I mean, look at this thing. It still looks brand new. And I just wanted to kind of point that out. So let me just put this over here. But this one here, it hasn't had as many rounds as that, no way. But it has had, you know, over 1,000 rounds. And it still looks pretty good. I love the crown, reverse crown on this. But this is a barrel sleeve over the barrel right there. So the trigger roll on this, okay, we just pulled down. Let me do the MR73. Very, very similar. Okay, but the Mongoose, I can't explain it. Like the actual, when you're rolling it back, they both kind of feel the same, with the Mongoose having a little bit more edge in the sense that it's easier to roll it back. It's very, very, very smooth. MR73 is smooth, but you can still feel a little bit more resistance in this one. That's the best way I can describe it. And to be honest with you, I think I enjoy shooting the Mongoose a little bit more. I do want to say, after shooting like 300 rounds of Magnums and 38 Specials, not all Magnums, mixed together, 357 Magnums and 38 Specials in one range session, I did 300 rounds. What I found was these Trausch grips. I love them, but this part up here where it creates a little bit of a beaver tail, in the web of my hand, I noticed that it started to peel the skin right there. And it started to draw blood. So that's when I had to put a glove on to continue shooting. But that's what I noticed. This part right here, especially at this edge, it's probably the 357 Magnum's recoil, was just tearing right into the web of my hand. I didn't even notice it until I was like, wow, what's that pain? And I saw blood in the web of my hand. That has never happened with the Korth Mongoose. And I believe it's probably because of these excellent nil style grips or stocks. They feel great in the hand. I love them. And yeah, I've never experienced that type of, you know, the webbing of the hand being, you know, ripped apart there from shooting like this. See the grips like that. So nil grips, I love them because they just feel awesome in the hand, and I can control this revolver perfectly. All right. But the Trausch grips, I like it because I still can control, but yes, the bottom part of this beaver tail section right here is what is just eating away at the web of my hand. So, I mean, that's if you're shooting a ton of magnums in one setting. I was just doing it because I was having a ton of fun shooting this MR73, and I just kept going and going and going. And yeah, I had some like younger crews were like, what are you doing over there? Because I was practicing drawing with the MR73, shooting, moving. I would have to reload, do reloading like this. I was just trying all different things with this thing. But I was having a grand old time. And this one here, yes, I do see a bit of wear occurring around the breech face, okay? The front of the cylinder, you know, I clean it up as best as I can. And the turn line or the ring around the collar, there's nothing you could do about that. But yeah, this is a, I like this revolver a lot as well, of course. So, and with this one here, if you put it in single action mode, you can see it has the hammer nose instead of the firing pin over here. So that's like the old school Smith & Wesson. So single action. Okay, let me do single action on the Mongoose. Yes, the Mongoose has definitely a lighter single action press. So what I said was, I think this was at 3 pounds and this was more at 4 pounds, I believe. So 3 pound single action and this one is almost 4 pounds. So you can definitely feel the difference of the single action pulls on each of these, lighter on this one. So is one better than the other? I don't think so. I enjoy shooting both of them. I will give the edge to the Mongoose for whatever reason. Maybe it's because I've owned this longer than this, but I don't know. It's weird. I feel a little more confident with the Mongoose, and controlling this under 357 Magnum is a breeze to me. This one here, maybe it's because that Trausch grip was just digging and eating right into the web of my hand, and it just, you know, just started to become uncomfortable. But I mean, they both shoot so well. They're both incredibly accurate. So I can't say one is better than the other. No way. One just looks different than the other. I like the looks of this thing because, I mean, they designed this in, what, 1973? Okay? And it's still the same after all these years. It's 2024. But, the Mongoose just has that little bit more of an edge over the MR73. The ammunition that I've been using has been this stuff here. This is just a target load, 357 mag, full metal jacket, 158 grain. So I've been putting a ton of this through this revolver, the MR73, and it's handled it just fine. No malfunctions, no issues, no nothing. I also tried some of this. I got a few boxes of this on hand, the Arms Core, another 158 grain version through this. Again, handled it just fine. I have a ton of critical duty on hand, so I tried a bunch of this through this, not a problem. And I have a few boxes of this Barnes Tac XPD, which is a 125 grain magnum, through this, and it's just fine. It's very controllable. So far so good with my MR73 at least. If it breaks, it goes out of time, I will definitely let you know. I mean, they say the MR73 has a stronger frame, and you can see that on the top strap right here, how much thicker it is than the Mongoose. All right, so look at the top strap on the Mongoose, then on the MR73, how much more material there is on top. So, French, German. French and German. I guess that's it. I don't want to keep rambling. This video got way too long. So let me know what you think. You know, as I said, if you really want to get a deep dive into these models, go on Google. There's plenty of people that have reviewed these revolvers. I'm just here talking, you know, out loud on what I think about them and my experience with them. So leave some comments below. Let me know what you think. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.